One should not be attracted to these mystic powers. Why? Because they are manifestations of external energy, Maya. Why they are manifestations of external energy? Because if we get attracted by these Ashtasiddhis, they will keep us encaged in this material world. And we will not get freedom from birth, death, old age, disease, which is the goal of this human form of life. And if he gets freed from this, if he is not attracted by this byproducts, Ashtasiddhis, then his progress towards me becomes unlimited. Atyantiki means unlimited. Gati syat. Gati means, Kapila is saying, Gati means progress. Syat means his progress towards me becomes atyantiki, unlimited. In Bhagavad Gita also, Krishna is saying that chapter on yoga, he says, Sukham atyantikam yattad buddhi grayam atindriyam. The sukha that a perfect yogi gets, it's atyantikam, it is unlimited. And he says, after you get that sukha, yam labdhva chaparam labham manyate nadhikam tataha. After having attained that sukha, the perfect yogi gets, chaparam labham, a greater gain, nadhikam tataha, it does not exist. And he's firmly fixed up. Otherwise, we have seen so many people, like Durvasa Muni, he lost his control. Vishwamitra Muni, he also could not control. So even after attaining Ashtasiddhis, we see that great sages and stalwarts who have attained perfection in the Ashtasiddhis have no control over their mind, or no control over themselves. But on the other hand, we see devotees who did not even aspire for the Ashtasiddhis, simply by becoming a devotee of the Lord, have controlled their senses perfectly well. So this is the position of bhakti.